A lot going on in boxing since we spoke last. Tim Zoo, Charlo fight postponed. Charlo has a hand injury, broke his hand in two different places. It happens to fighters.
Yeah, for sure.
I don't like the feedback. The fans think it's a conspiracy theory that someone's making it up.
And he put a picture showing his hand. I don't even have to do that. But he put a picture of showing that his hand is super swollen and everything. So
and those injuries do happen with fighters.
For sure. It's always the hand, knuckles, elbow.
And as I was telling people, fighters don't get paid for just training. You get paid to fight.
To fight.
So there's no reason why he would do all this training since July and then so close to the fight, not want to fight. When he spent $100,000 on the camp.
On the camp, for sure.
And Tim Zoo's here spending...
What's the one guy that was saying he's wanting to step in? The,
Was it Tony Harrison?
Harrison.
What do you think about Tony Harrison and Tim Zoo?
I think he's a good fighter.
Malik told me that he thinks the world of Tony Harrison.
I like Harrison, for sure. I like Harrison. Harrison, get down. I like Harrison.
So let me ask you this. If you had to put five fighters on the Mount Rushmore of boxing, who would you put?
Jesus.
You put
Armin on there, right?
Okay.
Everybody cheer for Armin.
Armin's very talented.
Sugar Ray Robinson is one of my...
Okay. You know, he won 47, lost one, won another 79.
That's crazy.
That is crazy. We'll never see that ever again.
Sugar Ray Robinson. Roy Jones, one of my favorite fighters right now.
Champ for 160 to heavyweight.
James Tony, another one.
Another one, 160 to heavyweight. You spar James.
That's spar James a bunch of times.
You guys had the same coach for a while.
We worked with Buddy for a little bit.
Yeah, time. Buddy and Pops.
Yeah, Pops.
He was in the corner.
Pops is always there in the corner.
Yeah. Before we continue, your favorite moments with James Tony in and out of the ring?
Out of the ring is just giving me knowledge, giving me game, always giving me great pointers, showing me different things. In the ring, sparring with him was fun. He was always talking shit.
What was he telling you? What kind of shit talking?
Shit talking?
Cause you don't talk.
Hey, just tell me you slow. I'ma knock you out. I do shit like that. But it was.
Did it make you laugh?
Nah, yeah, well, it was funny to me because I just still. Big
but he down, does hit hard.
No, Tony. Look, in my time sparring with him was as he was getting older and kind of past his time. But you couldn't slip up because he still had that beautiful up jab and everything, so you couldn't slip up.
Well, James Tony is one of those guys, probably like Charlo and Tank. Uh-huh. If you step in a spar. You chose to step in the ring to spar. There's no working with you.
There's no let's take it easy and let's work today. Work is like, it's a fight with bigger gloves and headgear on. That's pretty much that.
And James told me, he told me about training in general. He said his whole career, he just sparred every day, no mitts and a little on the heavy bag. That's it.
He was sparred.
Every day.
He was sparred.
Okay, so that's three. You had... Sugar Ray Robinson, Roy Jones, James Tony, two more.
Muhammad Ali for sure.
Okay, why?
You know, like a lot of people, they look at they go with Muhammad Ali because of all the stuff he gets out of the ring too. But in the ring, man, he was actually to be a heavyweight. He was fast. He was
only 6'3". He wasn't big. He wasn't like 400 pounds. Yeah. Very elusive. Chavez, Duran, Canelo, Mayweather, Pacquiao. Who'd you go from the last one, last spot? Hagler, Hearns.
I would probably go with Hagler.
He's right there.
Oh, here. We do have a picture of Hagler.
Rest in peace. Yeah, he passed away.
Hagler was a monster. Hagler was a monster.
He had a controversial fight with Sugar Ray Leonard.
That's why when people say who's the best and shit like that, man, that's always a hard answer because it's so many guys that are great that can fight, man. I mean, you can't like leave Mayweather out of that. It's crazy. So it's like everybody has their own. It's so many guys that you can put up with.
Let me ask Shadid real quick. Shadid, one question really quick. Your top five fighters in history. Who are your top five?
Ray Robinson, number one. Top heavyweight, Muhammad Ali.
Okay.
Joe Lewis is in it. Roberto Duran is there. And I think Ray Leonard and Hagler.
So you guys had two in common, Sugar Robinson and Ali. And he took it, but you can't argue with them because they're all right. Look, you can't argue with you.
Everybody had their own top five, and so many great guys in the it's hard to just say top five.
He put in his list Sugar Robinson, James Toney, you put Roy Jones, Muhammad Ali, and Hagler. Champ from 160 to heavyweight.
One thing I learned about Jones, I watched Jones as I got deeper in the boxing, there was a lot of flaws there.
You know who I would put in my top five? Manny Pacquiao.
Manny has to be there for what he's accomplished. James Toney definitely have to be it. It has to be more than the top five.
It's hard.
Ray Robinson is the number one of all time.
Why?
Look at his record. It's really incredible what he accomplished. I don't think that was ever to be accomplished again.
He died in poverty, which is really sad. He was the greatest fighter of all time. I read in a book, Muhammad Ali's brother wrote a book, Rahman Ali, where they went to visit him in a small little like hostel in LA where he was living.
That's really sad.
It is. I mean, you were the greatest ever in your sport. People worship you. You sold out stadiums. How does that happen?
Not understanding the business. He didn't have people around him that really, took care of the business for him. And there's really no reason why that should ever happen.
Happened to Joe Louis, too. Joe Louis.
Yeah, but once again, they got taken advantage of.
You have to have the right people around you.
Before the Muhammad Ali Act, Muhammad Ali, the people handling him, took 90% of his purse for years.
90%.
People around Muhammad Ali for the first few years took 90%. He only got 10% of his purse.
So you talking about the Louisville syndicate?
Yeah.
That's why he got away from
him. 90%. Yeah, he didn't know. It's crazy.
That he got away from
them. But yeah, it's in every sport, not only in boxing. When I see an athlete that made 20, 30 million and they end up with nothing, or they ask you for 10 bucks when they see you, it's sad because they made that money. That should have lasted their great grandkids.
Did you mention something about Duran? And what was that?
Your top five ever.
Well, really, I would have to go with weight. I think Duran was one of the greatest lightweights ever.
Yeah.
When he was a lightweight.
And he fought all the way up to 68?
Yeah.
He beat Iron Barkley.
Yeah, as a lightweight.
No one would touch him.
No one.
Even if he fought today, him and Mayweather?
Oh, he would stop him.
Hey, Duran against Mayweather, who wins?
Duran stopped him.
I think I was
like, why?
Duran stops him. Ray Leonard was stopping, Benitez would beat him, Hagler was stopping, Tommy was stopping. The slot fighters would beat Floyd.
Why?
From that old school. Floyd is great today. And that's, I like that. He's got, you can't take anything away from Floyd. He's accomplished a lot, he's done a lot. But when you compare him to Duran, the style of fighting, Duran would have been on top of him. Non-stop.
Well, I'm going to answer for Floyd because he's not here. But Floyd would say, I'm the greatest of every era, past, present, future. I'm 50-0. I beat everyone they put in front of me. I made the most money.
Well, he's accomplished a lot. But he's done more than others. No, Ray Robinson did more than he did.
Ray Robinson, I told him, was 47, lost one, then won 79 in a row.
Exactly.
That's crazy. He would, man. Chavez won 80 and 89 in a row.
Right, before he lost. I think Chavez would have beat him too.
Chavez told me that he would have beaten Floyd at 135, but at 140 he believes Floyd would have beat him. Something like that. But right now I want to ask you guys. The Cuban Mexican.
Yeah.
He was Cuban, lived in Mexico, was a killer, like destroyed everybody.
I think he should go down there. In the division.
But I'm going to be honest with you the way I look at it. If you're not American, many times people will not give you your credit. He was Mexican, Cuban, or Pacquiao's Filipino. They don't give them that props.
They have to give him the credit.
But I know, but I'm saying the way the media, the whoever mentions people as the greatest, they skip some of these guys. He was the real deal.
Oh yeah.
No one would touch him.
No one would touch
him. Yeah, I heard he had sick power. I talked to people who sparred him.
He was just so clever. Matter of fact, I was at the forum when he won the championship. I watched him win the championship.
You know who sparred him? There's a guy that's in the Hall of Fame. He used to come to Goosen Gym a lot. He coached kids. He told me that he sparred him, and he said he hit him so hard he's never been hit like that in his life.
He was so
yeah.
slick. He was so slick.
And it's the shots you don't see that hurt you. So really quick, who do you have in the gym today?
I have Prince, my little youngster.
How you doing, Prince? He's not little. He's taller than all of us.
Yeah. Then we have Armin. We have
Clinton. Armin in the house.
We have Clinton in the house. Then we have my Brandon.
So you're busy today.
I'm busy.
And your son's here. Who used to coach you at Goosen Gym?
What was that?
Who used to coach you when I met you?
Carlos Palomino.
Carlos Palomino. He told me he sparred him. Carlos is in the Hall of Fame.
That's good. Well,
yeah, so
look out for him.
Is he amateur pro?
Amateur.
Okay.
No
need to rush. I like your philosophy. No. Take your time, do it right.
Yeah.
There's no need to like
15-year-old.
Yeah. 15, you could go to TJ tomorrow and turn pro. Right?
Yeah.
No need to do that. He's gonna be like 6 feet, but he's gonna be
100 pounds.
He's gonna be like 6'7" by the time.
100 pounds.
You're like Diego Corrales. But that's good. It's a nice day at the office. Busy day at the gym. Everybody's working.
The greatest fight of all time is
Ray Roberts is the greatest of all time.
Yeah.
You ask 100 people, you may get 100 different answers. Everybody has their opinion. Who's the greatest fighter of all time? Who's the greatest fighter of all time? Who do you think is the greatest of all time? Who's the greatest fighter of all time?
Manny Pacquiao.
See, you get different answers. All right, later. All right, so there you have it right here. New era boxing. Stay tuned. EsNewsReporting.com. It's a crack recording.